In front of me, I have the newest phone from the company OnePlus. This is the OnePlus 3. I've previously tested the OnePlus 2 and the OnePlus X, both of which survived my durability tests. Let's see what happens with this new design, which is supposedly carved out of a single slab of aluminum. The OnePlus 3 was bigger than I anticipated. It is the same size as my Galaxy S7 Edge. After admiring the reflective logo on the back, let's jump into the scratch test. It does come with a pre-installed plastic screen protector, so I'll remove that. I have a set of picks that tell me where the hardness of the screen falls on Mohs scale of hardness. Each pick has a different material on the tip. The OnePlus 3 has Gorilla Glass 4 on the screen, so it's no surprise that the glass does not scratch until a level 6. A much deeper groove is left with a level 7 pick. But this is normal and on par with most every other smartphone that doesn't have a plastic screen, like the Galaxy S7 Active. The home button is made of ceramic, which is awesome. If you remember on my Galaxy S7 and LG G5 scratch tests, both of those have plastic home buttons that can scratch easily. The Galaxy S7 Active even scratched to the point of not working anymore. That won't be a problem with this OnePlus 3, there are zero scratches, which means that the fingerprint scanner can last longer. Thumbs up for ceramic. The 16 megapixel rear camera lens is made of glass, so even though it protrudes out of the back of the phone a little, it is resistant to normal scratches, unlike the plastic camera lenses of the Z5 Premium and the BlackBerry Priv. Clear pictures are always important. Onto that slab of premium aluminum. The phone is pure metal, so there is no thick coating of primer or plastic like you'll see on the LG G5, and you can feel it. The phone is cold to the touch. I tried scratching the reflective logo to see if it would pop out like the Lumia 950 XL or the Nexus 6, but it is very well embedded into the rear metal, so it won't be falling out on its own. So far, this device is a champion. The volume button, alert slider, power button, and even the SIM card tray are all made of metal, so there won't be any warping of plastic buttons like we saw with the old Evo phones. Even the speaker grille is made of metal. Little things like that add up when making a quality phone. OnePlus did not skimp on materials. Onto the flame test. The OnePlus 3 went with an AMOLED screen for this device, so let's see how it holds up to the extreme heat. The Galaxy S7 Edge lasted 14 seconds before turning white and not recovering. As you saw at the beginning of this video, it has a permanent white spot on the screen. The OnePlus 3 also made it 14 seconds before the pixels turned white, but after removing the heat, the screen slowly recovered and went back to normal. It was cool to the touch within seconds. Onto the bend test. While putting this much pressure on a phone at one time most likely won't happen in everyday life, it does tell us if the phone will survive any extreme accidents, and all of the tests together will show us what the phone will look like after 2 years of abuse. Cell phones are realistically the most abused pieces of technology on the planet, so if you haven't subscribed yet, I would recommend it. It's free, and ensures that you won't be buying a cheap phone in the future. The bend test scared me at first because the screen popped out of the frame, but even after exerting a lot of pressure, the phone still wouldn't snap. Remember that I've tested over 25 phones now. 4 of them snapped catastrophically, but the rest survived. The OnePlus 3 is a survivor. Even after bending both directions, the front and the back, there is no permanent damage. And the best part is there's no kinks in the metal frame either. Some of the Huawei phones would have permanent damage or kinks next to the power button or volume buttons after a hard flex. But the OnePlus 3 can be straightened out to look just like new. I'll open up the phone during my teardown and repair video to see what's inside and how to repair everything. It's fun to analyze tech from the inside. From a durability and build quality perspective, this is one of my favorite phones so far this year. I did do a behind the scenes snap story of the durability test on this phone. I'll also be snapping the teardown process. So if you're into disappearing videos, head on over to my Snapchat. Hope to see you around. Thanks for watching.